We shall discuss the next problem on bevel springs or disc spring. A steel bevel spring is compressed flat by exerting a load of 1 kN. For maximum compression, the induced stress is 1200 MPa. Calculate the thickness and outside diameter of the spring if the ratio of height to thickness is 1.6 and the ratio of outside diameter to inside diameter is 5. So here in this problem they have given the force exerted is 1 kN and they are saying that for maximum compression. So for maximum compression case we shall consider y is equal to h. So here you can see that this is h and y is the deflection. So if they have given maximum compression in the question, then we have to take y is equal to h and the force exerted F is equal to 1 kN and induced stress is 1200 MPa. So this is inner stress. We shall consider inner stress 1200 MPa. Calculate the thickness and outside diameter. They are asking us to find the thickness of the spring and outside diameter D naught. If the ratio of height to thickness is 1.6, they are given ratio of height h to the thickness t is 1.6 and the ratio of outside diameter to inside diameter is 5. They are given ratio of outside diameter to inside diameter as 5. So they have given this much amount of data. They are asking us to find the thickness of the disc spring and outside diameter D naught. We shall see the problem. So before proceeding with the problem, they have given the ratio D naught by Di. We shall calculate the values of M, C, etc. So in data handbook, we shall find out from figure 11.13. From figure 11.13, we shall calculate M, C1, C2. So the value of ratio of D0 by Di is 5. The ratio of D0 by Di. Here this is the ratio D0 by Di. Here this is the ratio is 5. So 5. So for 5, it is the last line here. So on the last line, we shall consider C1 is 1.8. C2 is 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, here 2.35. 2.35 and the value of M and the value of M is again it is 1.8. it is M will take as 1.8, C1 is 1.75. so this much amount of data we have considered. M is equal to 1.8, C1 1.75 and the value of C2 is 2.35. this is taken from figure 11.13, page number 184. So this is the data we have taken. Now we shall move on to find the values of thickness and D naught. In data handbook they have given the question. Here we shall take the force applied. Force applied, this formula 11.33a. So here in this problem we can substitute y is equal to h and in place of h we can substitute 1.6 times t. 1000 newtons they are given, 4 into, so here they are given material properties as E is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 MPa. In question they are given material properties E is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 MPa and mu is equal to 0.3. So we'll take here E is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 into y. For y we shall substitute h, and in place of h we'll substitute 1.6 t. M is 1.8. So here the value of M should be 0.8 because here they are given constant M. So here for the value d naught by di phi, you have to take this value, and this value would be 0.8. So I had taken 1.8, you have to take 0.8. M value should be 0.8. Here we shall change 0.8 into d naught square. So in place of d naught square we shall write it as it is. In place of h we shall write h as it is. So here h minus y, h minus y, so in question they are given y is equal to h, so this becomes 0, this term becomes 0, and this everything goes away, this term, and plus t cube. So in this equation we are left with t cube and d naught square. So this equation, it becomes on solving, it becomes d naught square is equal to 1803.32 t power 4. So this equation, it becomes d naught square is equal to 1803.32 into t power 4. So we shall call this as equation 1. Next we'll consider the stress at inner side of the disc. So for stress at inner side of the spring or disc spring, we shall take sigma I. We'll take this equation. Sigma I is equal to 4 EY by 1 minus mu square m d naught square into c1 into h minus y by 2 plus c2 t. This equation is obtained from 11.33 b, page number 183. So for this equation f, we have to write for this the equation as 11.33a, page number 183. Sigma I is 1200 MPa, they are given in the question, is equal to 4 into EY . So in place of h we shall substitute 1.60 minus y by 2. In place of y we can substitute h because y is equal to h, and again in place of h we can substitute 1.60. 1.6 t divided by 2 plus c2 into t. C2 is 2.35 into t, we shall substitute as it is. Again, this equation is in terms of t and d naught square. So on simplifying this equation, we'll get the value d naught square is equal to 5635. So we shall compare equations 1 and 2. On comparing equation 1 and 2, the LHS is d naught square. So we can equate these two equations and we can easily find the value of t. So on equating, we will get 1803.32 t power 4 is equal to 5635.38 t square. So on solving, we'll get the value of t as 1.76 mm. Shall approximate this thickness as 2 mm. So in question, they have asked us to find the value of thickness and d naught. So we have found out the value of thickness, t is equal to 2 mm. We can substitute this thickness in either equation 1 or 2. If we substitute in either of the equations 1 or 2, we will get the value d naught square. We shall substitute in equation 2. D naught square is equal to 5635.38 into 2 square. So d naught is equal to 150.14 mm. We'll get d naught is equal to 150.14 mm. We'll approximate this to 150 mm.